वेलकम टू द लेक्चर 3 ऑन ऑपरेशन मैनेजमेंट। टुडे आई विल एक्सप्लेन अबाउट द प्रोडक्शन सिस्टम्स। एज वी डिस्कस्ड डिफरेंस बिटवीन प्रोडक्शन एंड मैन्युफैक्चरिंग सिस्टम्स, टोटली टू डिफरेंट वर्ड्स हियर। मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इज रिलेटेड टू द मैन्युफैक्चरिंग प्रोसेस डन inside the organizations with some machines, okay, some operations. And production is all about related to the selling of the products, also finance, marketing, transportations, okay. But today we just discussed about the production systems. See, as we already know, production system is that part of an organization which produces its products or goods. Okay, as we know, a raw material as an input that is converted into a useful products. Okay, the end product should be useful products or goods with the help of some transformation process. Okay, the production is a basic activity of all organizations, and all other activities revolve around production activity. Means the output production system is the creation of goods or services, and that is satisfies the needs of the customer. This is most important rule of the organization, that should be satisfies the needs of customer, to collect the gather the needs of the customer from the market. Okay, parallel to this demand have to manufacture the goods with respect to the needs of the customer. Okay, first we have the what is meant by production systems, and after that we see the classification of production systems. The production system is that the part of the organization which produces its products, and production is a basic activity of all organizations, that all other activities revolve around the production activity. And the output of production system is the creation of goods or services which satisfies the needs of the customers. Okay, from the nature of production system differ from company to company, depending on how much output they generated and when it is required. Okay, based on it we can classify our production system as intermediate production system and continuous production system. We see one by one in detail. See, intermediate production system, again we have the sub-categorized project production flows, jobbing production flows and batch production flows. In continuous production system we have the mass production flows and process production flows. We see first one, that is intermediate production system. So in this type, wide variety of products and its sizes are manufactured by the production system. And intermediate product system situation are those where the facilities must be flexible enough to handle the production to different product design with different input characteristics. Okay, here the product design and its characteristics are different. Okay, under this system no single sequence of operation is appropriate, and therefore standardized materials or machines or process cannot be used here. Okay, and also under this type of manufacturing, production is done in lots of rather than continuous flows basis. It is done more often the basis of customer orders. Okay, which is also called as the modular design. For example, we can say in watch industry, components like inside the watch we have the strap, dial, movements, mechanisms are made in different colors and sizes and stored as an inventory. See, from these few basic designs, the components are combined differently to produce a range of men's and ladies' watches. Okay, or different components will be as a requirement of the customers have to produce here. Where this intermediate production also takes place in textile industry also for making shoe making, okay, for shirt makings. Okay, this finished product is within the range of standardized options. Okay, see that we have the project production and job productions are the most important topic here. First we say a project or a batch production. Under this system, you see in the next class, see the intermediate means something that starts and stops at irregular intervals of time. That is called as the intermediate. A customer order and customer specific. If you see the example of just I have given here, a goldsmith and tailor. It is non-continuous flow with the same size. But order the gold with the goldsmith with the required dimensions. Okay, also in tailor you have to order the as per the requirement of our shirt sizes. So goods are produced based on customers' orders. Okay, how you give the order? Okay, from customers you have to take the orders, then you have to start the produce the goods. Hence there is no need to inventory here, no need for stocking. Goods are produced on a small scale. Okay, the flow of production is intermediate. The design of products goes on changing, so that the system is very flexible. If we see some features of intermediate production system, the flow of production is not continuous. See, as per the order of the customer, we have to take that orders, okay, and then start the production. So it's all depending on the mind of the customers. Okay, a variety of products are produced because every customer having its own idea. Just now I take an example of a watch industry. Okay, everyone have unique ideas. Depending on that, have to take ideas from the customers, okay, then start the producing. But here the volume of production is very small. Okay, and general purpose machines are used to manufacture that products. Sequence of operation changes as per design. Okay, and production depends on customers' orders. This is most important features that are related to the intermediate production system. We can say it is a very small scale planning, a short range planning activity it is. Okay, so basically we have the three types here: a project production flows, jobbing production flows, and batch production flows. So this batch and jobbing, this batch and project are related to the same manner. Okay, we see the first one, that is batch production system. See, under the system, manufacturing is done in batches or in lots, either on the basis of customer orders or with the hope of continuous demand of the product. In this type of medium scale production takes place and appears somewhere between mass production and job production. Okay. In batch production, machines and equipments are made available for the next batch as soon as the production of first batch is completed. The best example for this type of the production system, we can say pharmaceutical industry, where different medicines are produced in batches. Other areas of applications are textile industry, also in machine tool industry. Okay, every machines having its different operations. Okay, in layout we have the different machines. From batch wise, you have to carry out different operations from that machines. Okay, if you come to the job production, in this system, goods are produced according to the orders from the customers, and the production is executed against a customer order, since continuous demand of such a item is not assured here. Means the need of each customer differs in the materials, plants, equipments and techniques may also differ. Therefore, we can say the product is classed by itself and it's separate from job for production purpose. What happens in some cases where there is no hope or a repetition of orders for exactly the same item, the job production calls for an adjustment of tools and equipments in carry out each individual job. Okay, so it is also called as the jobbing production flows in the mechanical engineering industry. Producing capital goods such as heavy special purpose machinery, aeroplanes, boilers, etc. And you, this type of production system, because specification of each order differ. With this type of production system, so is called as the jobbing in the mechanical engineering industry. The capital investment is comparatively low. Okay, and this is the flexibility in production is high compared to the batch production system. But here skilled workers are necessary, and the cost of production per unit is high in job production compared to the batch production system. Okay, these are the most important types under intermediate production system. Next we have the continuous production system. So the project example here given, the project production flows in airports, dams, roads, buildings. Okay, single and complex order here. Here we given deadlines for completion of these all works. Okay, the project manager will decides when this project will be complete. Okay, the example, the buildings of the flats. Okay, the buildings of the roads, the buildings of the dams and airports. A project production flows, company expects a single complex order or contract. An order must be completed within the given period of time and at an estimated cost. Okay, so these are just some characteristics of project production flows. Requirement of resources varies with production phases. Okay, every phases the requirement will goes on changes. Many agencies are involved for contracting the tenders and their jobs are interrelated. Generally delays takes place in completion of project if the labors are not there in that area. For example, you building the dam in the coastal area, sometimes the labor will not come to work there. As routing as scheduling changes, inspection is required. Okay, to make the schedule and routines every day, for that the inspection is compulsory. How much work is completed, then only the project will be moved step by step. Similarly, in job in production flows, the customer specification, it may be fixed cost and defined time. It may be repair shops, tailoring shops, and special machine tools. Just I explained. Okay. Second type, continuous production system. See, in this type, raw materials gets processed through a standard set of processes and sequences to produce a continuous stream of products. In a continuous production system, all the facilities and standardized as inputs are put through a series of successive connected operations. Or you can say, in other words, the same set of inputs flows through same routes and the same process convert them into finished goods. Okay, for example, such a type of production system is adopted by industries which produce products like petroleum. Okay, from petroleum you produce the petrol, diesel, okay, kerosene, like that. Also in chemicals, steel industry, sugar, etc. A continuous means something that operates constantly without any irregularities of frequent flow of the that process. In the continuous production system, goods are produced constantly as per demand forecast. Okay, therefore the customer demand to collect from the future demand, that we call as forecast, the prediction of the demand rate in the future, then to start the produce the goods. Goods are produced on a large scale for stocking and selling, and here the inputs and outputs are standardized along with the production process and sequence. So example, like you want food industry, fuel industry, okay, large scale industries here. What are the features of continuous production system? So mainly the flow of production is continuous and not intermediate here. Okay, the constant flow of process takes place inside the organization. Products are standardized because of the flow is continuously moving on the organization. We'll get the final output should be a standard product. Products are produced as per quality standards, and the products are produced in anticipation of demand, that we call as the forecasting demand. And standardized routing sheets and schedules are prepared here. See, mainly two types of the continuous production system. One is the mass production flows, another one is the process production flows. If you see the mass production flows, in this system of production, manufacturing is carried on continuously with the respect of the demand. Okay, the through demand of the product may not be uniform through the year. Say for example, steel, fertilizers, soft drinks, etc. And standardization is the key note of mass production. Okay, this mass production also called as the flow production system. A standardized raw materials and machines are used to produce standardized products through a standardized process of production. And in this type of usually a limited variety of products are manufactured, but it is in big volume in order to maintain a continuous flow of production. A plant layout is arranged according to the sequence of operations needed for manufacturing a particular product. Okay, here a plant layout plays very much important role to produce the continuous products. If in case the sequence of operations are changed, the layout of the plant also has to be changed immediately. Okay, so this system is also called as the flow production system. Okay, here we have some examples of toothpaste, soaps, combs, and pens. single operation, but a series of operations can carried out to produce these products. See, every day we using pens, okay, toothbrush, toothpaste, but we don't know how to manufacture these all products. Okay, every product should goes on the sequence of operations behind that. For example, you take pen. Okay, different operations can carried out to produce the end product as the pen. These different operations can carried out systematically in the continuous manner. That we called as the mass production system. Okay. Next we have the process production flows. Continuous production takes place in this type, but also raw material go through a few major processes maintained as a separate departments. Okay, this is some different from the batch production or mass production. A few production system where raw material go through a sequence of operation in quick succession. In process production, is finished product of one process is used to the next process as a raw material till the last process complete. Okay, so large industries like petroleum refinery, heavy chemical industries generally use of this system of production. So under this system, generally one principal raw material is transformed into several products. So maybe it is also called as the byproducts at different stages of operations. For example, crude oil is processed into kerosene, okay, the gasoline and other products. Okay, also the example of steel, cement, paper, sugar. Here a single product is produced and stocked in warehouses. Unit it is demanded in the market. The flexibility of these plants is almost zero because only one product can be produced. Okay, these are just some characteristics of the process production flows. The cost of production per unit is the lowest in process production. Also, the skilled managers are sufficient. There is no need of skilled laborers sometimes. Higher job security to workers because of stable and continuous demand of the product in the market. Okay, also we have the highest investment requirement for this production flow system. The changes in product variety cannot be easily interchanged. Okay, so this all about the production system. Whatever we discussed, the meaning of production system and classification of the production system. Okay, I will stop here. Next class we discussed about the productivity. Okay, thank you all of you.